Team Rush attempts to do the same, multiple shots getting into that high-efficiency boiler for the Blue Alliance. Blue Alliance also able to activate their first rotor in autonomous. They will be firmly in the lead coming into our teleoperating period. They're also halfway to the 40 kilopascals needed of boiler pressure to get their bonus ranking points. The Red Alliance activates their second rotor for 40 points, 35 points. All the Blue Alliance is in the lead by. But the Blue Alliance is working to extend that lead. They only need one more gear to activate their third rotor, and that is very quickly delivered by Grizzly Robotics. With that gear in place, Blue Alliance extends their lead by 70 points. Both alliances with one robot working on their boiler pressure. On the Red Alliance, we have Robohawks firing into the high-efficiency boiler. They build up pressure. Red Alliance now with 19 kilopascals. Blue Alliance with 25. And they're back at it on the Red Alliance. That is Robohawks firing into that boiler. On the Blue Alliance, it's Team Rush. Every three pieces of fuel that makes it into the high-efficiency boiler builds the pressure by 1 kilopascal. Red Alliance continues to work at it. They have got 31 kilopascals. Their pressure increasing rapidly with 38 seconds remaining in the match. Blue is still in the lead, but not by much. With 24 seconds to go, ropes are being dropped. It looks like Robohawks of the Red Alliance is still working on their high-efficiency boiler. Team Rush for Blue with a few left shots for that alliance. The Red Alliance has done it. 41 kilopascals of pressure. That will be a bonus ranking point for the Alliance as two of their robots make it up there ready for flight. Team Rush, the only Alliance robot to make it up. But it looks like Red may have come from behind at the end thanks to one additional robot making that climb. Let's see our official score. Here it comes.